This is Asian Americans in Jeopardy!
Hi everybody, I am your host, Kate Siaha on Rigg. Welcome to Asian Americans in Jeopardy. Yes, it's a pun. Yes, it is relevant to right now, and we are reoccupying and owning that space today with A4's all-Asian American game show celebrating Asian Pacific American Heritage Month. Now, the Asian American Arts Alliance is a 37-year-old nonprofit service organization which is dedicated to ensuring greater representation, equity, and opportunities for Asian American artists and cultural organizations through resource sharing, promotion, and community building. I know that they have been instrumental in my entire career as an art maker here in New York City and in America, and I'm very grateful that they exist. This program is being produced as part of the Coalition of Asian Pacific Americans' 42nd Annual Heritage Festival. Yes, we have one of the longest running Asian American festivals, cultural and historical, in the nation. So I want you to check out all the amazing programs during the month of May and learn about the many CAPA member organizations at capaonline.org. Now you can also check out my All Asian American Artists Downtown show on the Joe's Pub website this coming May 22nd. Go to Joe's Pub at the Public Theater and look for my mug and you will see me there presenting a lot of great Asian American artists who have been part of the A4 programs and beyond. So tonight we have three rounds and a total of 9 contestants. Yes, indeed, all Asian all the time, battling it out for the chance to play in the final Jeopardy round for the honor of becoming the Asian American Jeopardy champion. They're also playing for cash prizes for the charities of their choice, all Asian American related charities. So hopefully tonight, you're gonna learn a few things about Asian American culture and history. You're gonna have fun with some really iconic players. We've got champions, we've got historians, we've got cultural icons, we got everything. We got Broadway stars, you name it. Wait till you see who's playing today. But we're gonna start right now with the first round. Let's go meet our contestants. Coming to the A4 Jeopardy online special first is Anita Gundanna, co-executive director of the Coalition of Asian American Children and Families. Anita, I think I know the answer, but tell us who you're playing for today.
I am playing for CACF, the Coalition for Asian American Children and Families.
What a surprise. I hope you would be, because your other co-executive director might be upset if you weren't. All right.
That's right.
Next, coming to the stage, or I should say the virtual screen, is David Jung. He's an actor. He's the former U.S. and world air guitar champion. Dave, tell us who you're playing for.
I'm playing for the Asian American Legal Defense and Education Fund.
Awesome. Here comes to the stage our third contestant in the first round of A4 Jeopardy. It's Paolo Montalban, an actor known for playing the prince in Rodgers and Hammerstein's Cinderella. And he has also recently turned himself into a bystander intervention training facilitator, much needed in these very trying times for our community. So thank you, Paolo, for taking that initiative. And tell us who you're playing for.
I'm playing for Asian Americans Advancing Justice, AAJC.
All right. Well, okay. You're our first round contestant. So you're our guinea pigs for our special A4 Jeopardy featuring all Asian American answers and questions. I hope you're ready. I know I am. The categories for this round are food, film, activism, statistics, and politicians. So we flipped a coin backstage and Dave Jung, guess what? You get to go first. So let's have your first selection.
All right, I'll take film for 100, please.
Film for 100. This 2018 film was the first major Hollywood studio release in 25 years with an all-Asian cast.
What is Crazy Rich Asians?
That, my friend, is correct. And you are going to the next question on the board. You retain control and tell us what you want to do next.
Kate, I'll take film for 200, please.
Film for 200. Stick with a winner. This New York-based Indian-born director won a Golden Lion for Monsoon Wedding, but has actually never been nominated for an Oscar.
Who is Miranair?
That is correct. Mira Nair for 200. David, you're ahead with 300 points. Where would you like to go next?
Kate, I'll take film for 300, please.
Film for 300, asked by the world air guitar champion who shredded in Finland to bring our people to glory this 2020. Lee Isaac Chung film made history with 6 Academy Award nominations. Do you know what it is?
What is Minari?
That is also correcto. Thank you, David Chung, and rock on.
I'll take film for 400. I'll take film for 400.
He's sticking with a winning category. I like your strategy. This director won an Oscar for a film about smoking hot cowboy love and a couple other things too. David?
Who's Ang Lee?
Who is Ang Lee? I bet he would like to know too, based on that movie. What? That was a weird joke. Okay, David, where would you like to go next?
I'll take film for 500, please, Kate.
Film for 500 for the air guitar champion of the United States and the world. This Indian American producer is half of the famous duo known for their lavish period films.
Who is Ismael Merchant?
I think Merchant. That you have that correct. Oh, 100%. You are doing your parents proud, especially because they're Korean and they wanted you to go to Harvard. And instead, you played the air guitar. See what redemption looks like? It looks like this, Jung family. Okay,
never stop
David,
learning. Never stop learning.
Where do you want to go next?
I'll take politicians for 100, please.
Politicians for 100. She's the first vice president of South Asian heritage.
Who is Kamala Harris? Vice President Kamala Harris?
Kamala Harris. I don't know. You're kicking some ass today, David. Are the other contestants even going to get a chance to steal from you? Let's go to the next question.
So much brain. I'll take politicians for 200, please.
Politicians for 200. This senator from Hawaii never lost an election in 58 years, an elected official.
Who is Senator Daniel Inouye?
I believe that is correct. Yes, it is. Why do you know all of this?
Hey, man, he's a war hero. One arm.
Okay, let's go next.
I'll take politicians for 300, please.
Politicians for 300. She's the current senator from Hawaii.
Oh, who is?
Too slow. Other contestants. Ah! Your 5 seconds are up, Dave Jung. Who is going to buzz in to steal from you? Anita coming to the screen to steal the board from David. Anita, do you know?
Who is Maisie Hirono?
That, my friend, is absolutely correcto. All right, Anita. David, you are in the lead right now with 1,500 big points, mostly from the film category, but ooh, you're doing pretty good too, Anita. You're on the board with 300. Where would you like to go now?
I will do food for 100.
I'm surprised that you didn't pick that first, David. All Asians know everything about food. This popular Vietnamese sandwich is served on French bread.
What is banh mi?
That is correct. I don't even have to look at the answers to know that that is correct because I feel it in my tummy. Okay, what's next?
Food for 200.
Food for 200. This beverage is made with tapioca pearls.
What is bubble tea?
This is the drink of my people, and yes, it is bubble tea. Where would you like to go next, Anita?
Let's keep on food for 300.
Food for 300. Other names for this deliciousness are wonton, momo, mandu, gyoza, and shumai.
What is a dumpling?
What is a dumpling? That is correct. Moving on to the next one. Uh-oh. Let's see. Anita seems to be pulling into close proximity. And when's Paolo going to get on the board? Come on, Anita, what do you got?
Sticking with food for 400.
Food for 400. This cuisine is eaten in parlors from push carts.
What is dim sum?
Correct. Where do you want to go now, Anita? Food is treating you right. It's treating you right on this board.
Yeah, it's my heart. I'll stay there.
She's staying with her heart. Gentlemen and ladies, we're going with 500. And this is a video clue.
Hi, I'm Yul Kwan. You may know me as a winner of Survivor Cook Islands, but I'm also a product management director here at Google. All right, so this Korean-American chef is known for his momofuku empire and is a winner of multiple James Beard Awards. He also created, starred in, and produced the Netflix series, Ugly Delicious.
who's going to come in for the steal. I'm resetting your buzzers. Who wants to come in for the steal? Paolo, you've got... Oh, Paolo's going to come in. Paolo's going to try and come in strong and get those 500 points. Paolo, what do you think?
Who is David Chang?
Yes, that is correct.
Oh, no. I knew that.
You did know that. We all kind of knew that because we live in New York City. All right, Paolo, you now get control of the board. This is a really hot game, everybody. Paolo, where do you want to go?
I'd like to do activism for 100.
Activism for 100 from the, what are you? You are a bystander training facilitator, no?
Yes, yes.
You are. The undisputed unofficial Asian American photographer laureate.
Who's Annie Lay?
Incorrect. And also too slow. Who wants to try and steal this? Anita, come on in.
Who was Corky Lee?
Who was the wonderful activist and amazing mentor to many, many Asian American journalists. The wonderful, the unforgettable, and the beautiful. My heart hurts even thinking that he's no longer with us anymore. Corky Lee, may his photographs be an inspiration for many generations to come. All right, Anita, you are now taking control of the board. Where would you like to go next?
Nervous, but sticking with activism, 200.
Activism for 200. This civil rights activist moved to New York in 1948 and later became friends with Malcolm X when she and her family moved to Harlem.
Who is Yuri Kochiyama?
That is absolutely correct. Well done as the co-executive director of the Coalition for Asian Children and Families. I'm glad you knew the answer to that one. What do you want to do now, Anita?
I'll stick with it.
Your organization is asking you to stay with activism, so we're going to go for it. While he originally lost his seminal U.S. Supreme Court case in protest of the internment of Japanese Americans, he eventually prevailed when evidence was disclosed of the government withholding evidence.
Who is Fred Korematsu?
That is absolutely correct. A groundbreaking case and one of the, actually, I think it was the inspiration for the musical Alliance, if I am not mistaken, which went on Broadway. Is that right? Allegiance. You only know that because you did the workshop, Paolo.
That's right.
He did the out of towns. He made it work. And then they moved it to Broadway. All right. Here we go, Anita. You are still in control of the board.
I'll go back to 100 for statistics.
She's leaving the activists and going to the statisticians. Just like any good Asian parent would want for their child. Name the U.S. city with the largest Asian American population.
What is New York City?
That is correct. Surprising too, right? But correct. One would think it might be on the West Coast, but it's actually here. Okay, where do you want to go next?
Statistics for 200.
Statistics 200. A video clue.
Hi, I'm Richard Louie, news anchor, filmmaker, and author. Asian Americans make up what percent of the New York City population?
We are 15% and growing?
The only you would know the answer to that. We heard you, Richard. 15% is correct. And as the co-executive director of the Coalition for Asian Children and Families, it is good that you know that statistic. Where do you want to go next, Anita?
I feel the pressure. I will stay with statistics.
For how many?
300.
300. We're going in order. Okay. True or false? Asian Americans are the fastest growing racial or ethnic group in the United States.
Kate, that is what is true.
That is true.
Yeah.
We're coming for you. We're coming for you with our delicious food and our air guitar. All right, Anita.
All right. So Big Money. That's a wrong game show.
I know which one it is too.
No whammies.
No whammies.
What is that game?
It's press your luck.
Yeah. What is no press whammies. Your luck?
Stop.
I'll just keep going with statistics for 400, Kate.
Statistics for 400. New York City has how many Chinatowns?
What is four? Three. Sorry.
No, you're not allowed to change your answer. You're not allowed to change three. Your answer. That three. Is wrong. I'm not accepting it. Who wants to steal that? Somebody buzz in. Paolo has buzzed in. Paolo.
I'm going to just say, what is three?
That is correct.
Thanks, Anita.
Somehow, I don't know why I thought I just counted extra finger.
Okay, so where are we going now? We are going, Paolo is now retaining control of the board. Paolo's got 800, Anita is at 1600, and David is at 1500. There is a razor thin margin here, people. It's anybody's game. Paolo, where do you want to go?
I'm going to try activism for 400.
Activism for 400. This influential activist, author, philosopher, and feminist died in 2015 in Detroit at the age of 100.
Who is Grace Lee Boggs?
That is absolutely correct, my friend. And you know, whenever young Asian American activists speak to me about, you know, what to do, I say we have to look to the people who came before us, and Grace Lee Boggs is one of the best. Great books and movies and literature out there for you to look at. So everybody, that's part of this Jeopardy game, is for us to really get with our history and our culture. All right, Paolo Montalban coming back from behind at 1,200 points. Where do you want to go?
I'd like to try activism for 500.
Please. Activism for 500. This Filipino-American labor organizer, I hope you know this one, Paolo, do your people proud, rose to prominence with the Delano grape strike, setting in motion what would become the national farm worker movement.
Who is Larry Itlion?
That is absolutely correct. And you are now in the lead, Mr. Prince Charming of Disney's Cinderella. Where do you want to go now?
Oh, man. Politicians for 400.
Politicians for 400. It's anybody's game because the margin of difference is only 100 points on either side. In 1964, she became the first woman of color and the first Asian American elected to the House of Representatives.
I'm going to go too slow on this.
Sorry, Paolo, you're too slow. And it gives a chance to the other contestants to buzz in. Oh, there's Anita buzzing in. Anita, who do you think this is? The first woman of color and Asian American elected to the House of Representatives.
Who is Patsy Mink?
That is absolutely correct. Patsy Mink of Hawaii, also responsible for Title IX in the United States of America, which brought women to universities across America, desegregated them, and put them in, you know, they gave them opportunities to do sports and participate in higher learning and medicine and law. This woman is a hero of mine, and I'm glad she's on this board. All right, Anita, we've got two more questions left. We are at a very, you are ahead by 500 points. Let's see if you can keep that lead. Where do you want to go next?
Kate, I will try statistics. At 500, please.
Statistics for 500. The U.S. Asian population is projected to reach this number by 2060. A, 12 million. B, 46 million. C, 75 million. D, 100 million. Which is it, Anita? Do you know?
What is C? 75 million?
That is incorrect, people. Oh, no. You have a 1 in 3 chance of stealing this, even if you don't know the answer. All right, David, what do you think it is?
D, 100 million.
That is also incorrect.
Oh, God.
You both lose.
Oh, you better not.
It's not that big.
Can I take
it? You want to give it a shot? Look at Paolo.
I'm going to say B, 46 million.
That is correct, 46 million.
But also, I think my buzzer is not working, so.
Congratulations.
Yeah, but you still
got it. My buzzer wasn't working.
Thanks, guys. He's like, I wish my buzzer wasn't working. All right, Paolo, you are now in the lead, weirdly, after being behind for the entire game. Here you go. There's one question left on the board. It's going to make or break you, and it's going to make or break this game. Let's go, Politicians 500. You ready, Paolo?
Yeah.
This congresswoman proudly serves New York's 6th district. You don't know, do you? He doesn't know, everybody. He lives in New York and he doesn't know. Too slow. Okay. Who wants to steal this one? Anita.
I'm buzzing.
He's buzzing. Anita, you are buzzing. Okay.
Who is Grace Meng?
Oh my goodness. That is correct.
Yes. Awesome. Congrats. That was a great win.
That was so good. Everyone. David Jung, I take my air guitar hat off to you. Paolo, I tip my Prince Charming crown. However, the winner of round one is the inimitable and wonderful Anita Gundanna. Congratulations, Anita. You're going to Final Jeopardy, and now we're going to round two. Well, that was a lot of fun. Let's meet our second round contestants. Coming first to the Jeopardy virtual boardroom is Vinay Hira, a multidisciplinary artist and member of the Asian American Arts Alliance's first virtual residency cohort. So Vinay, you're used to being online and virtual in your cohort. Tell us who you're playing for in this virtual Jeopardy game today.
I'm playing for the Asian American Arts Alliance, based here in New York.
And the sponsors of this scintillating game. Thank you, Vinay. So exciting to have you here. Next coming into the room is Olivia Oguma, an actor, a video editor, a jewelry designer, and a solo backpacker. We're glad you made it here to your own living room. Olivia, tell us who you're playing for.
I am playing for NATCO, National Asian American Theater Company.
Yep, that's some. They're going to need a lot of money to get back after this rebuilding and reopening, and it remains to be seen if any of us are actually going to risk our lives to see the revival of Bye Bye Birdie by an all-Asian cast. I know I'm willing to risk my life for that. Speaking of risking their lives, here he is right now. I don't know why you're risking your life, Mark, but I just wanted to say that. You know, any musical theater actor is risking their life, frankly, 8 nights a week. But this one is a special one. We have coming to the Jeopardy room, Mark De La Cruz. He's an actor and a singer, best known for playing Alexander Hamilton in, you guessed it, Hamilton on Broadway. Mark, tell us who you're playing for today.
I'm playing for the Asian Counseling and Referral Service in Seattle, Washington.
Well, I know I need some therapy, so I hope you win and it helps sponsor my own personal PTSD recovering session. I wore masks before the pandemic, so now it's just a full-blown paranoia freak out for the rest of my life. All right, let's go into the categories and make ourselves feel a little better. The categories today are music, theater, visual arts, firsts, and celebrations, or as I like to say, celebrations. Okay, we flipped a coin backstage, and going first in this round is Olivia. Olivia, tell us what you want to come into the virtual background now and tell us where you want to go first.
Kate, I will take theater for 500.
All right, theater for 500. You know, Olivia is a child actor who's been on the boards for the last 15 years, so I am not surprised that she chose theater for 500. Okay, Olivia, I hope you know this one. I know this one. This is the oldest Asian American theater company in New York. What's your answer?
What is NATCO?
I don't think that is correct. And it is not correct. All right, the other contestants, you're up now. You have an opportunity to steal Vinay and Mark. Buzz in if you know the answer. This is the oldest Asian American theater company in New York City. Oh, Mark buzzed in. Okay, Mark, you think you know the answer? Come on the screen. Mark, unmute yourself and tell us what is the oldest Asian American theater company in New York?
What is Pan-Asian Rep?
That is correct for 500 big points in the first play of this round, and you steal from Olivia. Olivia, now it's giving up the time to Mark. Mark, you're going to be taking over the board. Mark, where would you like to go now?
All right. How about celebrations for 100?
Celebrations for 100. This holiday includes the giving of red envelopes.
What is Chinese New Year?
That is correct. What is Lunar New Year or Chinese New Year? All right, Mark, you're still in control of the board. Where would you like to go next?
Okay, let's stay with celebrations for 200.
Celebrations for 200. This colorful festival celebrates the eternal love of Radha and Krishna and good over evil. Too late. Sorry.
Name.
You're taking too much time. You snooze, you lose. This is New York City after all. All right. Okay. Vinay and Olivia, you have the opportunity to steal. And Vinay buzzes in. Vinay, unmute yourself and tell me what you think the answer is.
Namaste.
Namaste, Vinay. We are
Diwali.
That is also incorrect. You bring shame to your whole family in this moment. All right. Olivia, you want to give it a try? Oh, the answer is holy.
The answer is on the screen, but yes, sure. Screen.
How'd that happen? I was going to give you a chance to steal. Okay. Excuse you. This is Asian Jeopardy. You only get one chance to get it right, and then you're out of here.
Oh,
all right. Well, since nobody got that right, Mark, you get to remain in control of this screen. Mark, where'd you like to go next?
Okay. Let's stay with celebrations for 300.
Celebrations for 300. Okay, we're in it right now, and we'll celebrate the last day with Eid al-Fitr.
What is Ramadan?
That is correct, Mark De La Cruz. You retain control of the board, and you're still ahead with 700 points. Okay, we're going with
it. Stay with celebrations for 400, please.
Celebrations for 400. Vietnamese Americans call this New Year. Too slow. Who wants to steal this from Mark De La Cruz? Olivia and Vinay, you have the opportunity to regain control of the board. Vinay has buzzed in. Vinay, what do you think?
What is Tet?
Correct. You have now regained the respect of your family and the Asian American community with a correct answer and now control of the board. Where'd you like to go now, Vinay?
I will take music for 100.
Music for 100. This rapper's hilarious viral video rocketed her to fame and fortune. Too slow! Who would like to steal this from Vinay? Anyone want to buzz in with an answer? Olivia? Mark? Mark De La Cruz in the last second going for the steal or losing 100 points. What do you think, Mark?
Who is it, Awkwafina?
That is correct, Mark De La Cruz, and you regain control of the board. So Mark has a score of 400. Olivia is at a big minus 500, and Vinay is at 100 points, which is actually a respectable second place. Let's go, Mark. Where would you like to go now?
Let's stick with music for 200, please.
Music for 200. All right, Asian Americans, this groundbreaking flux artist did not break up the Beatles. Mark?
Who is Yoko Ono?
You know, I should have buzzed you because you were longer than 5 seconds, but I'll give it to you. That is correct, and you retain control of the board. Let's go.
All right. Music for 300, please.
Music for 300. Name this artist. This. Yoko.
I'm beautiful, I know, 'cause it's the season. But what am I to do with all this beauty? Biology, I am an organism, I'm chemical.
Too slow! Who would like to see? Oh, Vinay is buzzing in. Let's see, Vinay. Tell me who that is.
Leah Salasong?
I think you meant Leah Salonga. That is not all right. Correct.
I buzzed in, but I don't think you heard me.
I did not hear you. Do you know the answer?
I think it's Mitski.
Correct!
What is Mitski? Finally! Redemption!
You regained some of your lost points and you're now in control of the board. I don't know how you knew. See, Olivia is part of the new generation and she knows pop culture. So everybody at home, you might want to look up Mitski because she's got a really fresh
Asian singer.
She's an Asian singer.
She's Japanese. She's Japanese.
Well, you also have brought great pride to your Japanese family with that answer, Olivia. And now it's time for you to retain control of the board. Let's go.
I'm so excited. Kate, I will take, I got burned by this category before, so how brave am I? But I think I'll take theater for 300.
Oh, you're
brave.
You know, being a theater artist is a brave thing to do. This Filipino-American's first play was produced by Joseph Papp in 1978. 3 seconds.
Filipino American's first play?
2.5 seconds. 1 second. I'm really trying for you.
78.
Okay, too slow. Who would like to steal this?
No idea. Yeah.
Mark, Vinay, any ideas? You don't have to buzz if you don't want to lose the points. I understand your hesitancy. Okay, I guess nobody has this one. You know, this answer is actually dear to my heart because I starred in one of her plays at the Public Theater back in the year 2000. And you can show us the answer now.
Of course. Yeah,
too late. Jessica.
In my head, I was thinking Dog Eaters was not in 1978.
But her first play was produced by Joseph Papp at the Public in 1978 when he was in the vanguard of Filipino and Asian American artists. There were barely any of them, but they were all working at the Asian American Writers Workshop. They were working downtown. They were working in San Francisco. They were awesome. And she's awesome. All right. So, all right. Olivia, nobody got that right. So, fortunately for you and your ancestors, you retain control of the board.
I am so terrified to keep making this theater category.
You're now at minus 500 again because of that. Okay, let's go. Okay.
I'm gonna try and just take theater for 400.
I love a woman who doesn't learn from her mistakes. Okay, here we go. His play, The Chicken Coop Chinaman, was the first Asian American play produced in New York City.
What is Frank Chin?
Correct.
Okay,
Olivia. Okay, that's good.
Okay, I'm sweating.
100 now. You can do this thing. You can do it. What do you want to play?
I'm going to say fear for 200.
Fear for 200. She's a glutton for punishment, everybody. She's a glutton. All actors are. 2020 was going to be Asian Americans' year in New York theater. Yes, it was. You just have to name one of the 6 Asian American theater productions shut down by COVID last. Just one. You can try a couple, but name one of them, Olivia. I'm looking at the list right now.
One of the 6 Asian American theater productions as in
shut a down show? By COVID last year.
As in a show.
In not a show.
Just, not just a theater
not a workshop
company.
Or a reading. A show that was shut down.
That had Asian people in it.
You're stalling. You have 4 seconds.
Well, I'm stalling. Okay. Well, there weren't any. If people were in shows. Kelvin Moonlow was in Beetlejuice when COVID hit.
Doesn't count.
Marcella Cruz was in Hamilton.
Doesn't count. All right, too slow. Who wants to steal from Olivia?
I honestly don't.
You actually do know, but I can't tell you the clue until somebody else buzzes in. Who's going to buzz in? What was one of the Asian shows shut down last year in New York City? Vinay, Mark, you guys have any ideas?
I'm in the negative.
Okay, everybody's too slow. Olivia, we went to see a Cambodian rock band together. You and I were sitting in that audience.
Oh, Cambodian rock band and the play with the ladies who are like,
we're play the headlands and we're gonna die.
Let's just finish. Wait, do I have to go again?
Yes, you have to go again because nobody.
Let's take theater for 100 and
100 because
my career.
We're actors and we don't
care. I know the answer. Let's go. I know it.
Everyone's favorite Asian American theater guy.
Oh, come on. This is H. Who is David Henry Wong?
Yeah, well, that's why it's only 100 points, but you got that one right and you retain control of the.
What is Pan Asian Rep?
It's too late. Okay. Where do you want to go now?
Oh, dear, no. I guess I'll go to Celebrations.
Celebrations for 500. This is a courageous woman, everybody. She goes for the hardest answers first. Okay. What's another name for Korean Americans Thanksgiving celebration?
Oh my God.
Good luck to you, Olivia. Part Japanese, part Italian. Let's see how you do with this one.
What is
consolation?
It's like Chuseok or something or Chonsik. Chuseok?
Are we going to accept that, people?
What is Chuseok?
She said it. She said it. Are we going to accept that? I think we're going to accept that answer.
Oh my God! Yay! I only know that because of James Soule.
Okay, well, we will tell James Soule puts you into the
positive. Me
oh, that would have, I think he would have stolen that from you if you hadn't known. Okay, where do you want to go now?
I will take firsts for 100.
First for 100, Olivia. Here we go. He's the only Asian American ever to be nominated for Best actor.
What is Stephen Ewan? But
that is correct. Stephen Ewan. Yes.
If it were theater, it would be, if it were the Tonys, there would be so many. It would not so many, but it would be more than one.
Point taken. I hope you guys.
So I just wanted to say, and if it was first Asian American nominated, it would be, yeah, he's the first Asian American. You're right. Because the first Asian would be Mako.
Then here we go to our next category. But they see, everyone, did you just learn something from Olivia Oguma? The first Asian person ever nominated was Mako.
Pebbles, yeah, for Pebbles in the Sand. And yeah, so I do know some things about theater. Okay. Good job, Chuck.
Okay, go ahead. That was firsts, actually. Where do you want to go now?
I will take firsts for 200.
Firsts for 200. He's Saturday Night Live's first Asian American cast member.
Who is Bowen Yang?
That is correct. And you are now in the lead, Olivia Oguma, coming back from minus 700 points to plus 600. See what studying can do, kids? All right, Olivia, what's next? Where are we going next?
I will take first for 300.
First for 300. Ellison Onizuka was the first Asian American one of these, although we're not sure if he drank Tang. I'm sorry, that's too slow, Olivia. No.
Oh, no!
Want to win. This gives a perfect opportunity for someone to buzz in. Vinay and Mark, Ellison Onizuka was the first Asian American one of these. Oh, Vinay has rung in. Vinay, come on, tell me what you think.
What is astronaut?
That is absolutely correct. And a not so fun fact is that Ellison Onizuka was in a very famous space shuttle flight. Remember with Krista, what was her name?
Oh, Krista McAuliffe.
Correct. He was with the same team as Krista McAuliffe when they went up in space. So the first Asian American astronaut was part of that historic and heartbreaking part of our history. Okay, moving on from death and destruction, Vinay gets to take control of the board. Vinay.
I'll take visual arts for 100.
Visual arts for 100. Now, are you a visual artist, Vinay? Is that the cohort you're in?
Yes, I am. And for the life of me, this question is going to make me lose points.
Yes, it is. While currently residing in Japan, this artist developed her infinity net and polka dot paintings while living in New York in the 60s and 70s.
For the life of me, I've forgotten her name. So
you know who she is, right? You do. Okay, who wants to steal this from Vinay? Anybody? Mark De La Cruz has buzzed in first. Mark, do you have the answer for me?
Who is Yayoi Kusama?
That is absolutely correct, Mark. And she actually has an exhibition right now at the Botanical Gardens, I think. All right, Mark, you're controlling the board.
Okay, how about let's go to first for 400, please.
First for 400. She's considered the first Chinese American Hollywood movie star.
Who is Anna Mae Wong?
That is absolutely correct. And you are still in control of the board.
Okay, let's stay with first for 500.
First for 500. This performer co-hosted the first non-traditional casting symposium at the Schubert Theater in 1979. Don't you Google. I can feel you Googling. Too slow. Who's going to steal it?
Sophia.
Anybody?
Oh, yes.
You better buzz. There she is, Olivia. Okay. Olivia?
Well, actually, I don't know if this is right.
Do you want to say?
It's got to be an Asian person, right?
Right.
Who is J.D. Wong?
That is correct.
Because I was thinking of casting agents, and I'm like, they're not Asian, you know? She also became an amazing a talent agent and manager. And she was the first all Asian, she only handled Asian people as her clients. And she was a lot of people's first agent. When they came to New York and they couldn't get an agent, she was their agent, so.
Either you've got Wikipedia up on your screen and you are reading it like a teleprompter.
No, I know about Jeannie Wong a lot. Mark and I know all about Jeannie Wong.
Why? Did you do a show about her?
No, she was in the Canton Jazz Club. Oh. Yeah.
Where do you want to go next, Olivia? Come on. Round two is taking too long. Let's go.
Sorry, everyone's mad at us. I will take music for, oh no. Yeah, I guess I have to. I said it. 400, darn it.
Music for 400. This R&B artist won 2 Grammy Awards this year for Song of the Year and Best R&B Song.
Who is... Who is her?
Correct.
Oh, okay.
That is correct. Proudly repping. I think she's Hapa like us. Is that right?
She's Hapa. She's half Filipino, half Black, I think, right?
That is correct. Okay, moving on.
Is it still my turn? Okay.
Yes, it is.
I will take visual arts for 200.
Visual arts for 200. Everyone's in trouble. Okay. This artist, known for his paintings of the Lower East Side, passed from AIDS-related illness in 1992. Who are we talking about?
I don't think I know.
Too slow. Who wants to take that from Olivia? Paintings of the Lower East Side, AIDS-related illness, 1992. Mark De La Cruz wants to weigh in. Let's see if Mark knows the answer. Mark?
Who is Martin Wong?
Correct. Well done, sir. He was cool.
Yes.
He was the bomb.
Amazing.
Oh no, now you know. Amazing. Everybody at home, use your Google machine because he was awesome. Okay, Mark, where do you want to go next?
All right, let's stay with visual arts for 300.
You could still win this. Anyone could win it actually still. This artist represented the US at the 2013 Venice Biennale.
Don't know.
Too slow. Okay. Does anybody want to try and steal that from Mark De La Cruz, the first Asian American Hamilton on Broadway? V-Nay's making it in there. Come on, V-Nay. Tell me what you got.
Who is Ai Weiwei?
No.
Oh.
You are back in negative territory, V-Nay.
But story of my credit score, let me tell you.
You look great, the story of your credit score. But you know what? You're in positive territory when it comes to that shirt, my friend, and that hat. I would send you to Final Jeopardy just for your outfit. But that is not, unfortunately, that is not the right answer. The right answer is Sarah Z. Sorry, V-Nay, you're in negative territory. Stay. Okay.
Oh my gosh. So,
the control of the board goes back to Mark De La Cruz.
Okay. Let's finish out music for 500.
Music for 500. Come on, Mark. This pro-Tamil artist received a Grammy nomination for her song, Paper Planes.
Who is MIA?
That is absolutely correct. And one of my favorite rapper / fusion artists of all time. Not that anyone cares, but I care. All right, Mark, you still have control of the board and you are coming up strong behind Olivia. If you get these next two right, you may actually take over this game. Mark.
Ooh, all right, 400, please. Visual arts.
Visual arts, 400. This artist's work was featured on a postage stamp released in 2020.
Who is Ruth Asawa?
That is correct. Why do you know this?
I have those stamps. I actually have those stamps.
All right, Mark, you are now in the lead by 100 points, and there's one more category on the board, and you're in control. So here we go. Visual arts for 500. This MacArthur Fellow is best known for her photographs that skirt the edges of military conflict, history, and power.
I don't know.
Too slow. All right, everybody. We have a chance to put some money on the board, even though there's no money here. But you know what? We're Asians. We're competitive, and we want that. Who wants to try? Olivia's going to try. Olivia.
Was Annie Lay?
Yes. Why do you know that?
Because you told us we had to study really hard, and we all wanted to do good.
Good for you, Olivia. Good for you, all of you, for studying.
But she's also Vietnamese.
I did not study. I'm sorry.
Well, it shows, Vina, you did not study. But
you didn't
study.
You know what? Color coordination is a skill in itself, and I think you are most adept at that. All right. Then let's see the final scores. I can't see them anymore, but I think Olivia just won that round of Jeopardy by just by one question.
With the absolute worst start ever.
Olivia Ogawa comes from minus 600 or 700 points plus 1500. You're on your way to Final Jeopardy, Olivia, and we are going to the next round. Well, congratulations, Olivia, and we'll see you in Final Jeopardy. And now we're moving on to our third and final round. Before Final Jeopardy, let's meet our final group of contestants. First coming to the Jeopardy screen is Amy Chin, a genealogist specializing in Chinese American ancestries, who also serves as the president of Think Chinatown. Amy, tell us who you're playing for.
I have to be playing for Think Chinatown.
I am so happy to hear that. What does Think Chinatown do, Amy?
Think Chinatown creates programs that preserve New York City's Chinatown for everybody.
You know, it is so important, especially in these times of Asians in jeopardy, I think everybody knows what I mean, that we have organizations like yours to look to preserve our culture and history. I hope everyone checks you out online. All right, next, Kelvin Moon Lowe is an actor and the executive producer and writer of the upcoming TV comedy series, No Rice. Kelvin, hey, you're a hyphenate. How amazing to see you.
It's great to see you, Kate.
Tell us who you're playing for.
I'm playing for the fabulous National Asian Artists Project.
What do they do? What do they do?
They do lots of theater, wonderful stuff around here, giving lots of opportunities for Asian American artists. And also, Bayer Lee does wonderful work with students down in actual Chinatown here. So bring in the arts for the kids.
Amazing. All right. Well, speaking of arts, our third contestant is EJ Zimmerman. She's an actor who has toured in Avenue Q and made her Broadway debut as Eponine in Les Miserables, a true New York story. EJ, tell us who you're playing for.
I am playing for the Asian American Legal Defense and Education Fund.
I love it. Well, we've got three great contestants for this final round, and I'm going to tell you the categories now. Get ready for them. The categories in this round are whitewashed. So for this one, we're going to list the actor in the role, and you tell us the film or TV show. Ooh, this one's political. Television, fashion, literature, and my favorite, comedy. We flipped a coin backstage, and Kelvin, you're going to go first. So Kelvin,
ooh, me.
Sure. And Kelvin, where do you want to go first?
Kate, I would love to start with television for 100, please.
All right. The TV executive producer is sticking to what he knows. While technically Canadian, this series about the Kim family business is close enough for Korean Americans to relate.
What is Kim's Convenience?
That is correct, Kelvin. And we are moving on. Where would you like to go next on the board?
You know, let's pop around a little bit. Let's try comedy for 100.
I'm social. Let's do it. Comedy 100. The dress she wore in her stand-up special, Baby Cobra, is now in the Smithsonian.
This is a total guess, but who is Margaret Cho?
That is not correct, unfortunately, but that gives a chance for our other contestants to steal. EJ or Amy, would you like to buzz in and try and steal the board? EJ's buzzing in. EJ, come on and tell me who you think it is.
Who is Ali Wong?
That is absolutely correct, EJ, and you are now in control of the board.
Okay.
Where'd you like to go next?
Where would I like to go? Let's do, oh, I'm nervous. Let's say the same category. So comedy for 200.
Comedy for 200.
Oh.
This Pakistani-American made headlines and caused much drooling with his thirsty pic showing of his new superhero physique for his upcoming role as Kingo in Marvel's The Eternals. Too slow. Okay. Who wants to try and steal this one? Amy or Kevin? Kevin? Kelvin is coming. Did I just call you Kevin? How dare I?
That's okay.
You can call me Kathy. Kelvin, come on in.
Did I buzz in?
You did.
Oh, it's Kumail Nanjiani.
Who is Kumail Nanjiani? That is absolutely, ooh.
Yum.
Let's just take a moment.
Okay. Hello.
Everybody take, Amy, take a good look. You're not on the board yet, but you can admire it.
No idea that's what he looked like shirtless.
I mean, is it what he looks like shirtless, or did he Photoshop his head onto somebody else's body? That's insane.
That's what I look like shirtless.
All right, we're all very distracted right now. So, Kelvin Moon Low, you are now in control of the board and game. So go ahead.
Let's try whitewash for 100, please.
Whitewashed for 100. Anime Wong was robbed of this role of Olan in this Pearl S. Buck novel turned film.
I should know this.
Kelvin, you should know this. And so who wants to buzz? EJ's buzzing in. EJ, come and tell me what you think the title of this film
is. I think it's What is the Good Earth?
That is correct. I don't even have to look at my answer to know that is correct. And you are back in control of the board and you are in a zero position. I guess you got your points back. Okay, let's go.
You win some, you lose some. All right, let's do television for 200.
Television for 200. This sitcom, which takes place in Florida in the 90s, is loosely based on the life of Chef Eddie Wong.
What is Fresh Off the Boat?
That is also correct. Staying in control of the board, EJ Zimmerman of Broadway's Les Mis is now going to choose our next category. What is it?
Sticking with TV for 300.
Sticking with TV for 300. He's the original Sulu and fabulously sassy on Twitter.
George Takei. Who is George Takei?
Who is George Takei? Also right. I hope everyone at home realizes that we're doing this so that you also can play along and learn what you learn and know what you don't know and look things up on Google and on Wikipedia so that next time you're looking for role models or for examples of ways that Asian Americans have impacted culture, you can refer to some of the answers you heard today. EJ, where do you want to go next on the board?
Television 400, Kate.
Television for 400. Come on, pop culture. Let's go. She was Christina Yang on Grey's Anatomy.
Who is Sandra Oh?
Who is Sandra Oh?
She's the queen.
She is the queen. And we're going to move to the next question. Come on, EJ Zimmerman, ahead with 900 points.
Finish out the category, television 500.
Kill anybody's game. This comedian's show, Patriot Act, won an Emmy, Peabody, and 2 Webby Awards. And we want to know why it was canceled. Too slow.
I'm gonna get okay.
Well, you want that? Nope. Kelvin has no. Nope. Anybody? All right, you get to guess then, I guess. EJ, give it a shot.
I don't know.
Doesn't know. Well, you're gonna lose the points anyway, so you might as well try.
Margaret Cho, I don't
Wrong.
Know it.
Wrong. Okay. Does she lose twice because she didn't answer and then she
did? No.
My game right rules, like my mom used to say. Okay. Everybody lose, only I win. Hasan Minhaj. Okay. Who is Hasan Minhaj? All right. So, EJ, since nobody else stole that from you, you still are actually in control of this board and you are ahead by 200 points.
Oh, man. Okay, let's go crazy. Let's do literature for 500.
Literature for 500, taking a leaf out of Olivia's book and going for the gold. This author won a Pulitzer Prize or Pulitzer Prize. Is it Pulitzer or Pulitzer? A lot of debate on this subject. I like Pulitzer. This author won a Pulitzer Prize in 2011 for The Emperor of All Maladies, A Biography of Cancer.
I do not know this.
I do not know this leaves the door open for Kelvin Lowe or Amy to come in. Somebody want to buzz on that one?
Sometimes it's better to sit silently.
Sometimes it is better to sit silently. Also something my mother used to say to me frequently. Yeah. And then to be seen, not heard. Okay. The answer to this one, I will tell you since nobody has buzzed in on it. Why don't we show them the answer, everybody? Who is Siddhartha Mukherjee? All right, EJ, you are still in control of the board, but you are no
longer just
in control of the points at minus 100 points. Let's see if you can bring it back.
All right, let's try literature again. 400.
Okay, let's go. Literature 400. This author won the Pulitzer Prize. I'm going to say it differently this time, just for fun. This author won the Pulitzer Prize in 2004, The Interpreter of Maladies.
Sounds similar to the last one.
It does sound similar to the last one, but it is not the same person. Too slow. Who wants to buzz in?
Asians just writing about maladies, I guess. That's a big thing.
We're winning Pulitzers.
And they win Pulitzer. I know, but you see, Asians do fiction and they still do it better than everyone else when they occasionally just break out of the STEM courses. They work really hard at literature. Nobody knows? Okay, we'll put up the answer for you. Who is Jhumpa Lahiri? Nope, nothing?
Nope.
Crickets. Okay, all right. Well, EJ, you are still in the uncontrolled board, but now you're at minus 500. You want to
keep okay, but let's do literature 300. I'm convinced I'm going to get one.
Sorry, I'm chewing my bubble tea and laughing at the same time. This author's novels, Free Food for Millionaires and Pachinko, center Korean female characters for a change.
I know this one. Who is Min Jin Lee?
That is absolutely correct. Congratulations, you got that one, and you are coming back from minus land. Where do you want to go next?
Still in minus land, I think.
You are.
Let's do Whitewashed for 500.
I like it. Emma Stone as Captain Allison Eng.
What is Aloha?
Yes, that's right. What is something that made me angry for an entire year? All right. You're in control of the board, EJ, and now you're back in positive territory with 300 points. Where do you want to go next?
Let's do Whitewashed again, 400.
Whitewashed, 400. David Carradine as Kwai Chang Kane. Too slow. Amy, coming on in to be her first answer on the board. Come on, Amy Chin, what do you got to say to me?
I am a pop culture idiot, but I'm old enough to know what is Kung Fu.
That is correct. One of the worst offenses, because this was a role that was actually created and designed for Bruce Lee, which then they gave to David Carradine. Amy Chin, you are now in control of the board, and you are actually winning with your first answer. So let's see where you want to go next.
How does this even work? Whitewash for 300?
Whitewash for 300. Everybody seems to be doing well on these. Tilda Swinton as the Ancient One.
What is Ghost in a Shell? Something like that. What is The Matrix?
Well, you can't guess twice. Both of those were wrong anyways. Who wants to steal? Kelvin Lowe, come in. You're lucky I'm not taking double points off of you for two wrong answers. Okay, Kelvin Lowe.
The answer is, apparently I only watch comic book movies. What is Doctor Strange?
That is also correct. And you now retain. Look at this board. The difference of only 100. Oh, Kelvin has pulled ahead with 500 points, though. All right, Kelvin, you're back on the board and you're back in control. Where'd you like to go next?
I will finish out the category for Whitewashed, 200, please.
Whitewashed. Scarlett Johansson as Motoko Kusanagi. That was obnoxious. That is obnoxious.
Amy, I'm sorry. I think this is Ghost in the Shell.
That is correct. And apparently you do.
See, I was early. I was early with the answer. Don't I get points for that?
You get Asian points for that, Amy. Maybe not.
You get Asian points and activist points, but you don't get A4 Jeopardy points. Kelvin, where'd you like to go next?
Let's try fashion for 100, Kate.
Fashion for 100. Born Feng Lim in Thailand, this designer has a shop at 38 Great Jones Street.
Could be anyone here in New York City, but maybe I'll buy a wedding dress from her, but maybe I'm wrong. Who's Vera Wang?
Incorrect. Would like to steal this. Amy Chin might know the answer. Come on, Amy. You're a quiet riot.
I don't know. Prebon Garal?
Also wrong. And now you're putting yourself into negative territory with that one. You are at 0 points. Kelvin, you retain control of the
I'm board. Number three.
Ooh, ooh, ooh.
Okay, EJ, you think you know. You buzzed in. Let's go.
Philip, who is Philip Lim?
Correct.
Everybody same last name.
Not in appreciation that she saw the clue inside the clue. All right. Kelvin, I thought you were in control of the board, but you are not. EJ Zimmerman is coming back. Zimmerman.
Why can't you pronounce my last name right,
I'm
Kate?
I'm drunk, apparently, on bubble tea. I'm going to take another hit. Okay.
EJ, all right. Now I'm going to punish myself. With...
In fact, Kelvin's the only one with any points right now.
This is crazy. Okay, I'm going to punish myself with literature for 200.
This Viet Thanh Nguyen novel won the Pulitzer Prize for Fiction in 2016.
What is The Sympathizer?
That is correct. Or,
okay.
Did, what are you doing? Are you Googling or something?
No.
Were you looking
at
notes?
I'm an avid reader.
There's no cheating allowed in A4 Jeopardy.
I'm an avid reader.
A minus is Asian for fail. You know that.
I'll vouch for EJ. I'll vouch for her. She loves to read books. Okay. Whatever.
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 Apparently not the ones that were the 400 and 500 category, but yeah, the 200s and 300s, I'm there.
All right, where do you want to go now, EJ? You're still in control of the board.
Let's do fashion for 500.
Fashion for 500. I like it. This Parsons grad is known for his tailored silhouettes, but his HQ isn't really located at 10 Crosby Street. You're regretting that $500 choice now?
Yes.
Yes, you are, and you are too slow. Who would like to buzz in at this point? Everybody's on mute. Nobody wants to lose those 500 points with you, EJ. Nobody's answering, so we move on. The answer to this question is Derek Lamb. What? Did you know that? Nope. All right, well, you're still in control of the board with minus 300 points. Let's go, EJ. Show us what you got.
All right, fashion 400.
Fashion for 400. This boho designer was recently the subject of a retrospective at the Museum of Art and Design in 2019. Boho designer, retrospective. I'm giving you hints. I'm emphasizing the right Museum of Art and Design. Too slow. Okay, people, who wants to steal this one? Oh, I wish I could give you more clues. You're all gonna kick yourselves when I, oh, Kelvin?
Nope, I'm gonna win this game by staying silent, which is very opposite from what anybody knows of me. I'm just gonna chill in the 600. See that score there? That's where it's staying.
Boho.
Boho, who is Anna Sui? One of my favorite designers. Oh, yes. Yeah, okay, well, they didn't steal the board from you though, EJ. You could still bring yourself back from minus 700.
Let's do, what's the category? Comedy, the last category, comedy. We're
going comedy for 500. Go big or go home. Let's go. This comedian, also actor, writer, producer, and director, gained attention as a customer service representative in The Office.
Who is Mindy Kaling?
That is correct. And you are now less shameful than you were 10 seconds ago. Minus 200. Where do you want to go next?
Oh God, let's keep it with comedy 400. I'm trying to get out of the hole.
400. Let's get out of this hole. This Daily Show correspondent's first Netflix special was called Asian Comedian Destroys America. Too slow. Anybody want to try? Oh, Kelvin said he was going to keep quiet, but couldn't help himself because that's.
Couldn't help it.
Yes.
Because I love him, Ronnie Chang.
Correct. And you now retain control of the board. All right. With 1,000 points, Kelvin, they're your points to lose. Let's go.
I'm hoping Margaret is under 300 for comedy.
Okay. You want three? Okay. Let's see.
Let's try.
This OG comedian created a one-woman show in 1990 that was made into a best-selling book and feature film.
Margaret Girl, who is Margaret Cho?
Yes, you are correct. Who is Margaret Cho? Yes. Giving you 300 points and retaining control of the board.
Kate, I've got like new Asian superpowers on this thing now.
Even if you get every question wrong, you still could win. So let's see.
What?
Come on, let's go.
Let's give fashion for 200. Who is Vera Wang?
200. The Singapore-born Nepalese-American designer has dressed Kamala Harris, Michelle Obama, and Oprah.
I'm going to guess Vera until she sends me a dress. So who is Vera Wang?
Nope, that is wrong.
No, that's right.
Try and steal? Who wants to try and steal? I know somebody knows this. Who wants to try and steal this? You got nothing to lose. You might as well try. Amy, come on, brave one.
Who is Prerang Goral?
You mean Prabal Gurung?
Yes, that's what I said.
Prabal Gurung. I don't know if we can. I need to ask the judges.
Give it to her.
When we pronounce
it, get me out of zero.
We know them. Okay, Amy, you are now in control of the board.
Well, there's no way I'm going to win this one, but at least I'm not a zero.
Hey.
I'm at 200.
Amy of Think Chinatown throwing shade at EJ Zimmerman of Broadway. That's how
guys
for Jeopardy. Okay.
Rules
coming for each other. All right, Amy, what do you want to see?
Literature for 100.
We're playing for pride now. Literature. Oh, it's a video.
Hi, I'm Malik Pancholi. I'm the chair and co-founder of the anti-bullying nonprofit Act to Change. You may know this poet, a recipient of the MacArthur Genius Grant, known best for his novel On Earth, We're Briefly Gorgeous.
Poet. I'm drawing a blank.
Too slow. You lose those points and someone has the opportunity to steal. EJ Zimmerman coming in for the pride and honor that you tried to steal from her just now. EJ, who is it?
Who is Ocean Vuong?
Finishing strong, EJ Zimmerman. You have control of the board for the last one. Let's see what you're going to get. What is the question?
What am I going to get?
That was correct. Fashion for 300, EJ.
If this is Vera Wang.
Kim Kardashian, Chelsea Clinton, Alicia Keys, and Victoria Beckham are just a few A-listers who have worn her wedding gowns.
Who is Vera Wang?
Sorry, Kim, you didn't get to say it. She is back with only minus 200 points, but the winner of this round and going to Final Jeopardy with Anita and Olivia is Kelvin Moonlow. Okay.
It's unbelievable.
Well done, everyone. Well, that was a lot of pressure, and that was a really close game. You did really well. I hope those of you who played along at home learned something and are still with us, because we're going to Final Jeopardy now. All right, everybody, welcome to A4's Final Jeopardy, where we're answering questions about Asian America. And our contestants who won their previous rounds are Anita Gundanna, Olivia Oguma, and Kelvin Moonlow. Now, your Final Jeopardy categories are spaces and places, architecture, athletes, business, and history. We're going to start this round with Kelvin Moonlow, who had the lowest score of all the Jeopardy champions in the previous
round.
That's right. Well, you know, like you said, sometimes you have to sit in the background and be quiet a little bit to move ahead. Kelvin, where would you like to go first on our Final Jeopardy board?
Let us try, category I know nothing about, for sure. Athletes for 100, please.
I like the bravery. Athletes. He caused insanity in the garden.
Who is Jeremy Lin?
Correct. Lucky, right under the wire there with your 5 seconds. Oh, that is a nice Time magazine cover.
I didn't think Who is Lin was going to cover it.
All right, well, you're in control of the board. Where'd you like to go next?
The only reason why I'm going down this category is because I hope we get to Christy Yamaguchi. So. Let's go for athletes for 200.
That's your strategy, is keep asking the questions until you get the answer that you want. This speed skater won 8 Olympic medals and Dancing with the Stars.
Oh, I hope his picture is there too. Who is the delicious Apollo Ono?
You are correct, sir. Everyone knows nothing about sports. You're doing very well with sports. All right.
Mm-hmm.
Hello. See, you never know. Don't judge.
Never know. Let's run the category. Let's try for 300.
Let's
athletes.
Let's go, athletes for 300. This rockin' ex-wrestler is half Samoan and all muscle.
Do I just get to say, who's The Rock?
Who is Dwayne The Rock Johnson? I think you do.
Yeah.
Yes. Oh, let's just take a look at that one for a moment.
Yeah.
Okay.
His tattoos.
I know everything, not everything, everything. Okay. That's my boyfriend. Can't tell. All right, Kelvin, where would you like to go next besides The Rock's house?
Christy Yamaguchi for 4. I mean, athletes for 4.
This 1992 Olympic figure skating champion made a fitness video with the California Raisins.
The other one, and I love her too. I think, who is Michelle Kwan?
That is incorrect. Who wants to steal this from Kelvin Lowe? Anita, Olivia?
He's trying.
Anita is buzzing in. Come on, Anita, what do you think?
Who is Christy Yamaguchi?
This is a joke, right? That's a joke.
It's like your worst nightmare just came true, Kelvin. Okay.
It is my worst nightmare. Right.
I thought you were going to say Christy Yamaguchi.
Well, we
all thought you were going to say it, and then you didn't say it.
This is foolishness for myself.
Law of attraction. Okay. Anita, where do you want to go next on the board?
Let's finish out athletes for 500.
Tempting fate with athletes. None of us seem very sporty, but let's see what we know. Last year, this Asian American athlete shook the golfing world by winning the USPGA championship in only his second start in a major and barely a year after turning professional. Translation, not so famous. Who do you think it is?
Yeah. I know this is wrong, but who is Tiger Woods? And it's not.
Incorrect. Would anyone like to try and steal this from Anita? That is a hard no from the other contestants who do not want to be negative 500 points by making a faux pas. So let's tell you that the answer is, who is Colin Morikawa? This is one to watch, a name to learn, and let's move on. You still have control of the board, Anita, because no one tried to challenge you. So where would you like to go now to get back those 500 points?
Spaces and places for 100.
100 spaces and places. Located in Seattle, it's the only community-based museum in the U.S. dedicated exclusively to the history of Pan-Asian Pacific American.
What is the Seattle Asian American Museum?
Incorrect, but a very fine guess. Because I'm going to lose those points anyways. Olivia has buzzed in. All right, Olivia, what do you got for
the
me?
The Wing Museum. What is the Wing Museum?
I'm going to take it. The Wing Luke Museum of Asian Pacific American Experience. But I'll take it. The Wing Museum is what it's known of colloquially. And you get control of the board. Let's go. Have you been there?
Yeah, on tour. Actually, with Mark De La Cruz. Because he's from Seattle. So he made us go. Anyway. I will say,
need a question first before we can do an answer, but I like the spirit. Okay.
I would like to take architecture for 100.
Why not architecture for 100? This architect and sculptor, has an eponymous museum here in Long Island City.
I don't know.
Okay, who wants to try and steal that from Olivia? Architect and sculptor with an eponymous museum.
Oh, wait, I do know, but it's been too late.
Anita is buzzing in. Too slow.
Yeah. I don't know if I'm right, but who is Noguchi?
You know what? That is correct. Who is Isamu Noguchi? Noguchi, that is the architect of your people, Olivia. And now you two have brought shame on your family in this final Jeopardy round. Okay, Anita, you're taking over the board.
Kate, can I have history for 100?
You can. History for 100. This 1882 act is the first in American history to place broad restrictions on certain immigrant groups.
What is the Chinese Exclusion Act?
Yes, what is the very unfortunate and savage Chinese Exclusion Act? Kids, if you don't know about it, time to use your Google machines. All right, Anita, you have control of the board.
I will take history for 200.
History for 200. Asian American history. That's where we are right now. What did Executive Order 9066 do?
What is, it the incarceration of Japanese Americans?
Yes, it is. That is exactly right. We got a longer answer written out, but you got it. It authorized the evacuation of all persons deemed a threat to national security from the West Coast to relocation centers. In other words, it interned Japanese Americans, stole their property, and basically robbed them of most of their civil rights. All of them, actually, if you think about the life in an internment camp, which you can see in the musical Allegiance. Where would you like to go now, Anita?
Let's try history for 300, please.
300 history is treating you right. She made history as the U.S.'s second Indian American governor, the youngest governor in the country, not surprising. For an Asian American, and the first female governor of South Carolina. And yet still her family said, why did you not go to medical school? All right, what is the answer to this one, Anita?
I'm blanking her name, the Republican.
Too slow. Buzzers. Who's buzzing in? I heard it, but I can't see it. Who buzzed? Olivia buzzed.
It's Nikki Haley.
But who is Nikki Haley?
Sorry, but she has a really long actual, right? Indian name that she does.
Yeah, but we're using Nikki Haley because that's how people know her.
Yeah,
so
you're right. You're
Nikki
right.
Haley is correct, and Olivia takes back control of the board from Anita. Olivia.
Control of the board.
You have control of the board, and Anita just lost it as well as those points.
I guess I will say...
And the respect of her entire family.
I guess let's do business for 100.
Business for 100. Jerry Yang, a Taiwanese-American billionaire, co-founded this search engine company.
What is Yahoo?
That is correct. I don't know how you knew that. You're an actress, but that is correct. See, Asians are well-rounded, ladies and gentlemen, and people of indeterminate genders. We are overachievers and proud of it. And those Asian Americans out there watching this right now, I want you to continue to overachieve and learn more about some of these answers after the show. Olivia, you have control of the board. Where would you like to go next?
Let's do spaces and places for 200.
Places for 200. It's the oldest continuously running restaurant in Manhattan's Chinatown. It also created the bagel. I didn't know this. A hybrid between a bagel and a char siu bao. That sounds delicious.
I don't have any idea.
It was also recently in the news. And that was too slow. Okay, Kelvin Moonlow.
I'm thinking, what is Shun Li?
That is incorrect. That is on the Upper West Side and delicious, but you are looking for what is Nam Wah Tea Parlor, which they recently organized an event to try and save because they lost so much business during the pandemic. And it is because it's the oldest continuously running restaurant in Manhattan's Chinatown. There's a lot of crowdfunding and organizing around it to try and keep it alive. All right, Kelvin, you are incorrect. You lost points. And also you have restored control of the board to Olivia. Olivia, where would you like to go next?
Oh dear. I'll take architecture for 200.
Architecture for 200, why not? This architect was only 21 years old when she won the competition for the Vietnam Veterans Memorial.
I think it's, who is, it's Maya Lin?
What did you say?
Who was Maya Lin, but.
All right, I'll give it to you, even though that was also too slow.
I don't think that's right.
It is right. I don't know how you know it. Why are you asking me why you know it? You just know it.
No, because I thought Maya Lin. Okay, I was thinking that.
Take a lesson from Kelvin. Be quiet right now. Don't lose the points. Who is Maya Lin? Is correct.
Take the points. Take the points and run.
Okay, I'll take the points.
Run.
All right, Olivia.
I'll take business for 200.
Business for 200. After losing a presidential run, this entrepreneur is trying to be New York's next mayor.
Who is Andrew Yang?
That is correct. Who is Andrew Yang? Olivia Oguma, where would you like to go next?
I will take spaces and places for 300, Kate Rigg.
Spaces and places for 300. The city became a popular destination for Chinese immigrants hoping to strike it rich during the California gold rush.
What is San Francisco?
Correct. What is San Francisco, California? All right, Olivia, you are still in control of the board. Now you are ahead by a hefty 900 points.
We are going to spaces and places for 400.
Places for 400. This place is home to the largest Vietnamese population outside of Vietnam. And you are too slow. Who would like to steal this one? The home to the largest Vietnamese population outside Vietnam. I'm looking for a buzz. Anita is buzzing in, bold and strong. Come on, Anita.
I'm hoping a state counts. What is Minnesota?
Not only did you get the state wrong, but you also got the city wrong. What we're looking for County, California. What is Orange County?
Oh, no.
California. She is firmly in a shame spiral now with minus 500 points. Kelvin is sitting pretty at 0 points, but at least not bringing shame on his family to the same extent. And Olivia is ahead with 500 lucky points. Olivia, you are still in control of the board. Where would you like to go now?
Let's do architecture for 300.
You know, by the way, that Anita's going to come back, right? This is how this game works. People come back. This architect with partner Todd Williams was tapped to design the Obama Presidential Center in Chicago.
Oh, it's a guy who is
It's like Billy something. I have no idea.
A guy who is like Billy is nothing.
I have no idea.
Before. Would anybody like to come in and try and steal this one? Come on, it's Final Jeopardy. We knew the questions were going to be a little harder.
I have no idea.
Ooh-wee.
Nope, they're sitting there letting you lose those points. The answer is actually Billy someone. Points for that. All right, Olivia, still in control of the board.
I don't want control anymore.
See what happens?
I give control to someone.
There's going to be no Final Jeopardy. We're all going to be at zero, and I'm going to win. I have to choose my charity. Okay. Olivia, where do you want to go?
I will do spaces. No, why did I just say that? I guess, yeah, Jesus.
Space is a blazer for 500. Oh. Risking it all, Olivia Oguma. Yolani Palace, the only official royal palace in the United States, is in this city. I'll say it again.
Oh, what is Honolulu, Hawaii?
Correct. You see? You're still in control of the board, though. Where would you like to go next?
I guess we'll do business for 300.
Business for 300. Indra Nooyi is one of the world's 100 most powerful women, according to Forbes, and became the fifth CEO of this multinational soft drink in the company's history.
I'm just going to wild guess. What is Pepsi?
That is correct, and not so wild. Not so wild. She's actually a very prolific speaker on business and women in business and women of color in business. Mm-hmm. She actually has done a lot of sort of forward-thinking mentorship in the last.
I knew the name and I knew it wasn't Coke, but she
does that because you know.
Yeah.
My name. All right, Olivia, where do you want to go next?
I will take business for 400.
Business for 400. This entrepreneur changed the world with his Zoom technology, which we are on right now.
Who is?
Nope.
Bill Gates. He's not Asian. I don't know.
He's not Bill Gates. Okay. He's not even Asian American.
I know. I'm sorry.
Or an Asian person. All right. Let's go. Anita is buzzing in.
How about who is Eric Yuan?
That is correct. Anita, where do you want to go?
I will take business for 500.
Business for 500, coming in from the minus 100. He's the co-founder of Alibaba, stock ticker Baba, also in that. But more importantly, he owns the Brooklyn Nets.
Who is Joseph Tsai?
Yes! Yes, you got it right. It's weird that you knew that. Nobody here is supposed to know about sports, and yet we've all heard of them. It's weird how media works. Okay, Anita.
History for 400.
His murder ignited a national outrage and a new movement for Asian American rights in 1982.
Who was Vincent Chin?
That is correct. So let's move on. All right, Anita, where do you want to go next on the board?
Let's close out the 400s. Architecture for 400,
please. Architecture for 400, all right. He designed both the Louvre Pyramid and the National Gallery of Art in Washington, D.C.
Oh, I know this.
Final Jeopardy, too slow. Okay, who wants to steal this one? Olivia, Kelvin, do you know?
I'm buzzing.
Buzzing. Okay, Kelvin, you're in. What do you
think? Oh my gosh, I went. It's I am Pei.
That is fantastic. That is the right answer. And now you have control of the board. And you're back with us, Kelvin. You're back from zero. You've got 400 big points. Where do you want to go next?
Oh no, I just feel like I'm going to negative territory with either of these categories. So let's go with history, 500.
Okay, history for 500. Asian American history. What was the result of Wong Kim Ark's landmark court case? I'll give you a clue. It happened a long time ago.
You know, immigration's a big thing to me. Maybe I know this. I think it birthright citizenship.
That is correct. I will accept that. It granted birthright citizenship to everyone born in the U.S. regardless of race or nationality. That was a big case.
Yeah.
All right, Kelvin, you're coming. You are now in the lead. My goodness, with 900 points. One question left, Kelvin. So I guess I know where we're going. We're going to architecture for 500. You nervous?
It's a negative 500 coming right here.
The Japanese architect won the Pritzker Prize in 1995 and is known for his use of materials like glass and concrete. Any ideas?
Who is George Takei?
You know what? I wouldn't put it past Uncle George.
No, he could do anything. I love
it. Oh, Olivia is buzzing in. Olivia, do you know this one?
Tadao Ando. He's from Osaka.
Tadao Ando, that is correct. Doing your Japanese ancestors proud, Olivia. Tadao Ando. All right, well, that was a crazy final Jeopardy round. And of course, we are now on to the final Jeopardy question. Now, this is the part where the contestants get to wager up to the amount of money that they have in the bank. So for Anita and Kelvin, that's $400. For Olivia, that's $1,100. And they are playing for the win, everybody. So I'm going to tell you now your final Jeopardy category. Once you hear it, you will make your wager. The final category is iconic moments. Send your wager to us in the chat, and then we'll see. Someone's gonna be the champion. Someone's gonna win. All right, everybody, I have your wagers, and this is your question. Sandra Oh uttered this famous phrase at the Golden Globe Awards in 2019. I want you to send that to me in the chat, and then we will reveal your wagers and hopefully the grand champion of A4 Jeopardy. Let's go, everybody. All right, I've got my answer from Olivia. I have my answer from Kelvin. Anita, did you send me your answer? All right, I have everyone's answers, and I have their wagers. So let's start with Kelvin, who wagered $398 of his $400 because you didn't want to get into that negative territory.
No.
All right. And Kelvin said, I love being Asian. Anita bet $400 of her $400. Now that is go big or go home. And her answer was, what is, this is a moment of change. Olivia also bet $400 of her $1,100 total. And her answer is, it's an honor to be Asian,
which is on Mark's shirt that he was wearing.
Which actually, if you guys have been paying attention, was on Mark De La Cruz's shirt that he was wearing in this very game earlier today. So I'm sorry, Kelvin with an L.
And Olivia.
Well, Olivia, you have won with a grand total of $1,500. Kelvin, you are in second place with $2. And Anita, punch drunk from the A4 Jeopardy game and the Brooklyn Nets, you are at $0. Olivia, tell us who you were playing for again.
I'm playing for the National Asian American Theater Company.
And tell us what we can expect from them coming up.
On May 19th, stream for one night only, Thornton Wilder's Our Town with an all-Asian American cast. And I am one of the people in it. And it's a benefit for to celebrate Asian American Pacific Islander Heritage Month. So, yeah.
Which is what we're in the middle of right now. Right. All right, everybody. This was a wonderful game. I hope everyone had a great time. We want to wish everyone on behalf of the Asian American Arts Alliance a happy APA Heritage Month. Please check out all these contestants on their social media. Hit them with a follow, hit them with a like. Learn more about your history and your culture. Make sure you stay tuned to A4's activities and get on their mailing list. It's important to be joiners right now. It's important for our community to come together. That's why we're here tonight. So I hope I see you all out there on social media, and I hope you had a great time. Thank you very much.